Hallo zusammen. Am Sonntag ist der Start des Robotaxis in Austin, Texas. Ich bin hier gerade in Michigan und habe jemanden neben mir, der kann uns vielleicht ein paar Fragen dazu beantworten. Das schauen wir uns gleich zusammen an. Vorher gibt es hier immer noch den Hinweis auf den Sponsor, der dieses Video möglich macht. Bis gleich.
Tesla Welt wird präsentiert von Shop for Tesla. Hier gibt es nachhaltiges Zubehör für euer Auto. Ob ihr Gummimatten braucht, Schutzblenden, Jackpads oder auch Performance-Pedale. Hier gibt es jetzt auch schon viele neue Produkte für das neue Model Y. Mit meinem Code erhaltet ihr 10% Rabatt.
Ja, hallo und herzlich willkommen zu einer neuen Ausgabe der Tesla Welt. Ich stehe hier mit John, dem Gründer des Tesla Owners Club Silicon Valley. Ihr kennt ihn vielleicht von X und wir reden heute ein bisschen zusammen. Das tun wir auf Englisch, aber ich werde vielleicht euch eine Übersetzung liefern. Yeah, hi and welcome to Michigan. This is Tesla Welt, this time in English. I'm here with John, the founder of the Tesla Owners Club Silicon Valley. You know him from X, and we're going to talk about Sunday, because on Sunday is the Robotaxi launch in Austin, Texas, right?
Yes.
What do you know about that?
So the first wave of invites has already gone out. And again, we're talking, it's happening 2 days from today, the time we're talking. And it's invite only right now. And I have a couple of friends who got the invite. And it sounds like you can bring a plus one. And they've laid out a bunch of parameters for what's okay and what's not okay. But you can literally go in. They encourage you to take a, you know, photos and video. It sounds like, you know, the whole showcase is going to be no one in the driver's seat. And then they're going to have someone from Tesla probably in the passenger side. And then you and another person will be in the back. Again, this is just a showcase of what's going to be possible. You're going to be able to hail the rides or use kind of like the Uber or here in the US, Lyft as well. So you're going to use the Tesla app. You're going to hail the ride and be able to go in and just experience all of it. So it should be pretty cool. Like, again, I don't know if this is going to be the first wave rollout and then they're going to do multiple waves after that, or if this is going to be something like they're launching it and then anyone that comes to Austin is going to be able to do it. But it sounds like it's all going to be done through the Tesla app that, you know, that they've been waiting for. But this is what we've all been waiting for, right? 2018, I got my first Tesla Model 3, and that's when I realized it's like Amazon is no longer a bookstore. It's what it is today. It's delivering, it's making pharmaceutical goods, it's making t-shirts. I mean, anything you can think of. And, you know, this is really the moment that Tesla moves in from being a car company into a fully autonomous vehicle company and really robo-taxis and being a Turo and Airbnb all in one. And really, again, this is just, you know, I've been waiting for 7 years for this. And so I know it's going to take maybe a couple more years before I can download this on my Tesla and be able to have the full robo-taxi go out. But launching in Austin is just a huge milestone for Tesla, for the community, for investors, and just people that have been following this journey all these years.
What do you think is going to be the perception by the public, or even maybe in the Tesla community by this launch?
Well, so I think, yeah, I think you're talking, I like how you brought that up, because it really is going to be like, you know, what may the media think? What are the Tesla community people and potentially investors? I think for the community, again, I actually was the first public Tesla FSD beta tester back in October of 2020. So that's when it was like launched initially for public viewing. And so now you fast forward 4.5 years later, this is the moment, like we've all been kind of waiting for this. And, you know, back when I look at 2020 versus now, I mean, Tesla has come so far to the point where you can do park to park now. I mean, you've experienced FSD for the first time now. And so
that's,
I think,
amazing.
Like, yeah, I mean, and in a lot of ways, you kind of are experiencing that robo-taxi in your, you know, in the Model 3 and the Model Y, S and X have all of that. But this is really like for them to literally not have a person in the driver's seat and to display that and showcase that. This is, again, it's just, it's kind of like, it's really just the kickoff of, you know, the future of what this company, what we've all been waiting for. And one thing I want to call out is before the humanoid robot came to be, Elon, you know, in our interview that we did with him, he said that Tesla is worth what it is today and potentially the biggest market cap in the world if it solves full self-driving, right? Yeah. Or it's worth nothing. Yeah. So for him, he didn't ever want this to just be a car company, right? Yeah. And so for him, this is what they've been waiting for. And I think he's been overly optimistic. But for him, this is where the whole enchilada is, as we say in the US.
Yeah.
So I think that's the community, right? Everyone's excited. This is what we've been waiting for. The news and the media, I think it's, I wouldn't be surprised if there's practically no coverage. I mean, I think there's going to be some coverage, but I think they're waiting for Tesla to drop the ball or something bad to happen. And that's where really where they're going to like try to cream it and put a bunch of false information out there. I do know from some people I've been talking to on X, they're reaching out, like other like Reuters and some of these companies are trying to get information about the launch event and trying to ask people for access to their footage and all this other stuff. But, you know, the world's watching, right? Again, because you have Waymo, you have, you know, Zooks and all these other companies that are doing this, but no one can do it at the scale that Tesla can. Because again, Tesla can make the volume of all of Waymo's fleet in one day. You know, or
yeah,
a couple of days, whatever it is.
And I really love that they start with a Model Y and not with a Cybercab or something else, because they could have made a bunch of Cybercabs for that, you know. What do you think?
And what do you think significant about that? I want to pull that out a little bit, because they're already making
it. It's our cars.
Yes.
You know, it's what we drive.
Exactly.
And I think
you can buy it today.
Yeah. And I think that might be maybe something that the public will be surprised about, that it's not some crazy kind of Waymo car with a lot of LiDAR on top of it and, you know, a lot of sensors that you see all around in San Francisco, which is impressive, of course, and they're doing a good job. But it's just a regular Tesla, basically, from the line. There's nothing special about it.
And they're making these cars already profitably. Yeah. There's no other car company really in the world right now that can make an electric vehicle profitably. Tesla's literally like the only one. And then you have other companies like BYD who are putting out tons of volume. But typically they're like half the price. And again, they're not doing it profitably. They're scaling it. And as we know, it's heavily subsidized by the government in China. So for Tesla to be able to do it, you don't have all these, as you said, like, I think by the time they build a full Waymo, it's what, $180,000. And so
even if it's less, it's not a couple of thousand euros like in a Tesla, you know,
exactly.
Like, and it's already included in the normal price.
And the other thing too, again, I'm talking US dollars here, like Kathy Wood has said that from ARK Investment, that per mile, again, I don't know what that 1 mile to kilometers is, that costs about $2 to $4 for in an Uber.
Yeah.
Okay. But at scale with Tesla, it's going to be 25 cents.
Yeah.
So you're talking a tenth of the price, and you're not going to have to deal with drivers. You know, I know at least here in the U.S., women are going to love that because, you know, they don't want to be bothered by some random driver. They would rather just get in and feel safer.
Yeah,
right?
I think it's even for guys for like us, it's good. It's nice. You have some privacy. You don't need to make a conversation with somebody if you don't want to. You know, like
exactly.
Yeah. Good stuff. I mean, we've been talking about this a long time, and you know, how's the Tesla sales in the US lately?
Yeah, you know, well, I think it's actually I think it kind of just depends on like what part of the US, but really, like, I think the focus and part of the conversation has been, you know, Europe sales have been just tanking, or like Australia and all these other parts of the world, right? But I think what we're actually seeing is that I think I just saw a stat last week of the sales trending in June, that Tesla sales are actually 20% of the total market volume of what's happening in Europe. The sales are up an insane amount in places like Singapore, Australia, Hong Kong. You're just seeing sales go through the roof. And I think everyone was just like, oh, the company's dying, the brand's tanking. And I think Elon did make a comment that Europe at that moment when he was doing the interview was the weakest market, where everything else is strong. And now you're seeing the reverse happen, because you can't sell, I mean, it's still this from Brian of Futuraza, you know, you can't sell a car that's not on the road or that hasn't been built yet. And that is what they did, is they completely revamped the whole production line. So in the US, I know it has slowed a little bit also too, you know, but it has slowed for all OEMs or really legacy auto in the US in general. But again, now, you know, it'll be interesting to see the results, because in about 10 days, the quarter ends, and we'll see how it is in the US, because I do know that they're fully ramped now. They have some of the best deals on the cars. Like, you can pretty much get into one for, I think it's like something like maybe $499 with pretty much like $2,000 down and you can lease it for 2 years. For the Model Y, it's even cheaper for the Model 3. I think it's $349 a month for $1,000 or $2,000 down. So you can't beat that. It's pretty much at parity with the Toyota Corolla.
Yeah. I mean, in Europe, there has been some markets which are down where you see some impact.
Norway's up a ton.
But Norway
like
is
200%,
up a ton.
Yeah. Something like that.
And they're kind of a role model also for electric cars, yes. Because they are like over 90% of the new vehicles in Norway are electric cars now.
Yeah.
And normally what happens in Norway happens also in other markets afterwards a little bit. I mean, I don't think it's zero impact, you know, for some regions in Europe, but all what I heard, also for the, I can just talk about Europe, where I have my information from the Gigafactory in Berlin, for example, they sell into 38 markets. So even if there are some
couple of bad ones,
markets down, they can ship product. That's actually what they're doing. And so I think overall, also on a worldwide scale, it doesn't really.
Yeah, it's gonna be the same where even in the US versus even China and the amount of markets that they're shipping to. I think it's just going to be kind of, it just depends. We all know that there's some brand damage from Elon joining Trump, but I think people made it so polarizing and they amplified it way more than it really is, right? Like, I think even in the US, we got to the point where I had people from Europe actually hitting me up, hey man, are you okay? I've been seeing people like just going after Cybertruck owners. Yes, there's been cases of that, but you know, unfortunately, we know what legacy media does with Tesla and Elon. It just pulls a false narrative.
Yeah, and too early also. Exactly. You know, you can't say in February sales are down because...
Yeah, it's the best-selling car in the world. And not only that, you shut down four factories and you completely redesigned it. Sure, like the front got a complete new facelift. The back got a complete facelift as well. Completely redesigned with the full 5-foot light bar. You also have...
different suspension.
Yeah,
stuff like that.
different right. Suspension. Not only different suspension, you have the back screen in the back as well, along with the ambient lighting going all the way around, the front facing camera, the rear folding seats that go down in 4.5 seconds, which is an industry standard now. But either way, it's, you know, Tesla has completely redone it. They didn't just give it, like with the S and X, they just give it a small couple facelifts here and there. They completely redesigned this. So, I think, you know, I do think I'm still bullish that, you know, the Model Y is going to be the best selling car in the world again for the second year.
Yep. They said so.
Exactly. So I think it's going to happen. And I think, you know, we all just need to see what's going to happen. And Tesla having this robo-taxi event is just going to help them continue to steamroll and activate some big things. We know new products are coming. We know the Cybercab production is going to be happening later this year, if not early next year. The humanoid robot, they're going to launch a couple of new products, maybe family-sized vehicle, whatever that may be. But again, it's not about a car company. This is about an AI robotics company. I mean, we drive a robot on four wheels, and we're going to see all of that happen with not only the robot, but this company is already going to be producing the robotaxi that is happening in a couple of days.
Maybe last question, just a prediction from your side. Do you think the robotaxi or the Model Y in Texas and Austin will have a different FSD version, a new version that we might get afterwards on all the cars? I mean, in terms of capability, just.
Yeah. I mean, I think clearly we know that the robotaxi is on a different model right now. I think that's a given. I know that there's going to be a ton of updates and iterations that they're going to have over the next like 3 to 12 months. It's just going to be night and day because they're getting more and more information. And you actually see, shout out to Josh West and some of these other guys who are looking at all the robotaxis on the road and scoping them out. You know, they're collecting so much data right now. So, but I do think that the good thing is, as you said, they're making on the Model Y, and that if you own a Model Y, one of the newer ones, you're going to be able to get that. Obviously, if you have a Hardware 3, maybe it's going to have to be upgraded, or you're going to have to sell your car, to be honest. But you're going to they're making the car that will be able to drive itself. I mean, we're seeing that in Austin right now.
Looking very much forward to it.
Yeah.
I might head to Austin on Monday, so let's see if I can see one at least, get somebody who was already in it, maybe. We will see. But it's just awesome to be here and to experience that. And a big shout out maybe to the Tesla Owners Club of Michigan, who is making this great event here, the summer meetup. We're here for the next 2 days, and it's awesome to have all this community here. And thank you very much. It's really an awesome event.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. Look out for the epic light show by Simon from xlightshow.io. It's going to be great.
Thank you very much, John.
Yeah, thank you.
Falls ihr diesen Kanal unterstützen wollt, dann schaut mal bei Shop for Tesla rein. Hier gibt es nachhaltiges Zubehör. Ihr bekommt 10% Rabatt auf jetzt alle Produkte und ihr unterstützt damit auch weiter den Kanal. Diese Sendung wurde freundlicherweise vom Tesla Owners Club Helvetia in der Schweiz und dem TFF, dem Tesla Fahrer und Freunde e.V. unterstützt.